challenged by the horns and goes out there without Ezekiel Elliott and still balls out of control. Clearly not a Cowboy fan, man, but I want to see that kid succeed. Definitely. Yeah. Yeah. So we'll definitely see how he does. Just like I said, we're late for the break. All right, we're going to take a quick little break. When we get back, man, a little entertainment talk. Still talking about 2003 and all the events of that year. We got the top 10 movies of 2003 coming up. Don't forget at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, the Ryan Stewart Show here on Two Live Stews Radio. Don't go away. Back in 3 minutes. Stay right there. Stay right there.
Hey, what's up, sports fans? You're looking for a different type of sports talk show, something you haven't heard before? You gotta check out the BS3 Sports Show every other Saturday on Two Live Stews Radio, 1 p.m. Central Time, 2 p.m. Eastern. Sports talk at its finest. Always have great guests playing some good hip-hop. You don't want to miss it. Make sure to tune in to the BS3 Sports Show every other Saturday at 1 p.m. Central Time, 2 p.m. Eastern.
Let's go.
Welcome back to the show. Throwback Thursday, 2003. Once again, in 2003, them Saint Lunatics had it going on. Shingy, Murphy Lee. Hey, the number to the show is 404-822-5467. Just chopping it up, man. Talking about these sports and everything else going on in the world. Started off the day, man, talking about punk ass 45. So I almost feel like the Riddler from Batman. Old school Riddler. Old school Batman. TV. 4 o'clock. Weekday afternoons after school. Donald Trump is such a fan of the Confederacy, man. I don't understand that. That didn't make sense. The man was born in New York City. Yeah. It's clearly evident that he has support from those right-wingers, your neo-Nazis, your skinheads or whatever, and he doesn't want to publicly, talk bad about them. And that's clearly what's going on. And he triples down on it today, not doubles down. He triples down on it today and saying, it's sad that this country's moving these beautiful statues. Man, fuck them goddamn slave owners. What? And somebody said something in the chat room, made a good point. I can't remember who it was. It might have been Angry Black Man. It might have been Angry Black Man. Pulling down those statues doesn't erase history. History is history. Those are just darn reminders of some racist ass slave owners. What? And pull them goddamn statues down. Who gives a fuck? Fuck you and your statues. All right, today's date is August 17th, 2017. Celebrating a birthday today is Robert De Niro. As I mentioned a couple of days ago, my third favorite actor of all time, behind 1 and 1A Samuel Jackson and Denzel Washington. But De Niro's not far behind, man. Award for Best Actor for his role as Jake LaMotta in the 1980 boxing film Raging Bull. And an Academy Award for Best Supporting Actor as the role of Vito Corleone in the 1974 classic The Godfather. Celebrated films like Taxi Driver, Cape Fear. People forget about Cape Fear. If you're a greenhorn, go back and check out Cape Fear. Now, I don't know how it translates in today's, movies. Like, a lot of times, movies that you watch that are old, they look dated, and, the acting methods and everything is kind of off. It looks old. It looks like an old movie. But, man, the first time I saw Cape Fear, that was kind of like one of those movies where it made your ass jump every time, every scene. Like, they had something to make you just jump out of your shoes. Good-ass movie, good-ass acting. Like, that dude really was scary, the character that he played in Cape Fear. So go and check that out if you haven't seen it, if you're a greenhorn. Also celebrating a birthday today, on the other side of the scale, is Sean Penn. Not too much of a fan of Sean Penn. Wasn't he banging Madonna? Anyway, happy birthday to Sean Penn. He turns 57 years of age today. Oh, yeah, De Niro turned 74. I'm not sure if I said his age. Also today celebrating a birthday is Rudy Gay. Turns 31 years of age. Happy birthday to Rudy Gay. And that's it. We don't have any other big birthdays to talk about. I don't think we had any Stewie's birthdays. But if you got a birthday coming up, man, you want me to shoot you or give you a shout out, shoot me an email at Doug@TheDougStewartShow.com. That's Doug@TheDougStewartShow.com. We love giving birthday shouts out. Yes, sir. So ESPN analyst Byron Scott says the fantasy football auction sketch that aired on network is unacceptable, but he's not calling for the producer to get fired. The network has already apologized for the sketch, which showed a white man auctioning off players, many of them black, to a white crowd. Critics say it resembled a slave auction. Stars like Kevin Durant and Odell Beckham made it clear the sketch was not cool with them. So we asked Scott, and this is all coming from TMZ, who often appear on ESPN's The Jump, how he felt about the situation. It is unacceptable. I thought we've come a lot further than we have. Obviously, we have not. We have a ways to go. Let me say something about this, man. It was a big controversy yesterday in the Two Live Stews Facebook radio chat group where some of our Caucasian brothers, man, were trying to defend, and ironically, they both were Caucasian brothers. They were trying to defend this fantasy auction as just that. It was a fantasy auction, and this is done every single year. This is not a new thing. Fantasy auctions aren't a new thing. I think the difference is the twist on it this year of having this live auction, us just coming off that movie Get Out, where the exact same scene, if you saw the video of this ESPN auction thing, like it was the exact same setup as the scene where they were auctioning off the black guy in Get Out. And for the guy to hold up the little fan with the picture of the guy on, and then in the climate of the United States in the Donald Trump era, the last couple of years, social injustice, police brutality. Like, the optics of it was just bad. It was just bad. And, you know, so people got back and forth in it yesterday in the chat group. I'm not going to get into details. We actually had to silence one particular guy who was going off of one of the poodles. Not going to give you names. And we had to silence that dude because bottom line is he was out of bounds in his thinking, I think. Personally, and also I thought the dude was kind of posting high in the chat group and had all of this keyboard courage where he wouldn't have done or said the same things to this person in their face, especially if this person had their brother or their boyfriend or their husband with them. Yeah, I mean, so it was a real ugly thing in the chat yesterday, man. Listen, we come in peace, man. We love everybody on the Doug Stewart Show and the Two Live Stews Radio Network. But I guess maybe if you're not black, you can't understand why we would be sensitive to auction blocks, you know, and faces of black dudes on a fan. We're sensitive to shit like that. I mean, it is what it is. We'll move on from it. It's no big deal. It's just really a lot of times your personal, perspective on things, not a big deal. We're going to move on. But for our Caucasian brothers and sisters listening, to summarize this thing, we kind of sensitive to auctioning off black people. That's the best way I can put it. That's the best way I can put it. We're going to move on, but that's the best way I can put it. And lastly, speaking of Caucasian brothers, man, y'all pray for the nature boy Ric Flair, man. I mean, pray for the nature boy, man. Ric Flair remains in critical condition with multiple organ problems 5 days after being admitted to an Atlanta area hospital, according to a statement by his fiance. Damn, Ric was about to get married? Wow. Wendy Barlow released a statement on Facebook on Wednesday afternoon addressing Flair's current condition and rumors that have circulated since news of his health surfaced. Quote, just want to give an update to my friends and family as I have been unable to talk on the phone without crying and just feel shocked over the events, she wrote on Facebook. I took Rick to the hospital Friday night with severe abdominal pain. From that moment on, it all seems like a nightmare. Multiple organ problems. Barlow specifically denied rumors that Flair's surgery was on his colon. So y'all play for the Nature Boy, man. The greatest to ever do it. All right. Hey, back in 3 minutes. Back to the sports. This is the Doug Stewart Show.